Well, folks, this was a very big week for resignations. Longtime Alabama University head coach Nick Saban, 6 national championships at Alabama, he retired. Bill Belichick, head coach of the New England Patriots for 24 years, 6 Super Bowl victories, he retired. And of course, the saddest news of all, the one nobody saw coming, Chris Christie officially dropped out of the 2024 Republican presidential race. Everybody knew this was going to happen, but a lot of us kind of thought, like, maybe he'll get through Iowa. But even with only a few days to go before Iowa, Chris Christie is like, I can't do it anymore. I'm done. And nobody, by the way, is happier about this than Nikki Haley. Nikki Haley is, of course, within striking distance of Donald Trump in New Hampshire. The latest polls show her 3 to 4 points away from tying Trump for first place. And those polls, by the way, that difference between Haley and Trump is all within the margin of error. So it is a statistical tie. But now that Chris Christie is dropping out, the question becomes, where do his supporters go? Obviously, you're not going to get probably anybody who supported Chris Christie that's going to go to Donald Trump. Because Chris Christie's entire campaign was built upon, I hate Donald Trump and you should too. So it's not like people are going to be like, man, I like Christie, but I'll go for Trump now. No, you love the Trump hater. You love the not Trump guy. You're not going to Trump. You can go to Ron DeSantis, but that's kind of Trump light without the charisma. So what do you have left? You have Nikki Haley. So if Nikki Haley does manage to get the 1% or maybe 2% of supporters that Chris Christie had, because the latest national poll earlier this week had Christie at 1%. If Nikki Haley gets that, it may be enough for her to win New Hampshire. Now, she's not going to win Iowa. That's a given. Donald Trump is like 50 points ahead of everybody in Iowa. He's going to take Iowa, so he gets that first prize. But next up, a little bit tougher, New Hampshire primary. If Nikki Haley can pull off a victory in the New Hampshire primary, suddenly you've got a race on your hands. Because what comes just a little bit after New Hampshire? South Carolina, where Nikki Haley was in fact governor, a very popular Republican governor, after serving as a very popular Republican state lawmaker. So if Nikki Haley can win one of these early contests, that could be seen as momentum. And then, of course, we will also, around that time, probably after New Hampshire, maybe before New Hampshire, DeSantis and Vivek Ramaswamy are going to go bye-bye. Like, they're already halfway done anyway. DeSantis's campaign has been on life support. So we could be looking at a very real race very quickly. But we'll have to see how it goes. We'll see where Chris Christie's supporters go. If they go over to DeSantis, maybe it keeps his campaign alive for another week. I don't see that happening. But if they all go to Nikki Haley, suddenly the dynamic of the Republican primary starts to get a little bit more interesting. Ring of Fire is just a few subscribers short of hitting that 1 million subscriber milestone. So if you're not already subscribed, please go ahead and do so and stay up to date with all of the latest from Ring of Fire.